Been outside. They say a storm is coming, but we made it to day 31. Come on, anybody glad tonight?
Hallelujah.
Come on, stand to your feet if you're glad. Come on, it's the last night. You didn't come out here in all this weather to just sit and look at us. Come on, I know you didn't. I know you didn't. I know you didn't. Are you glad this tonight? Are you glad tonight? Are you glad tonight? Are you glad tonight? Are you glad tonight? These 31 days, God has done some things. He has done some great things. He has done some, well, I guess I'm glad by myself. He's done some great things. I know the team is happy. Yes, 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 yes. Song says, you know, and we are glad.
Hallelujah.
Come on, clap those hands. Come on. praise him. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Clap those hands if you're glad. Yeah. Yeah. Clap your hands if you're glad. He's done some great things. Yes, he has. Yes, he has. Never left me. He's kept me. He never left me. He fed me when I was hungry. Yeah. He kept me. Oh, come on, come on. Praise him. Y'all know he has. Come on. He's been good.
Hallelujah. It's night 31, but it's not over yet. It's not over yet.
That's right.
It's not over yet. Hallelujah. For tomorrow marks a transition into 21 days of prayer.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. 21 days. All is invited because there will be about 20 minutes of word about the names of God. So we invite you out. We invite you out to lay at the altar, to pray to your God, our God, and what you're expecting and believing from him on these 21 days. There's power in prayer. There are scriptures that we need to read and stand on daily for the manifestation of what he says to come to pass.
Yeah, yeah,
so we have 21 days. How many days? 21 days. We can do it. Press on in. We can do this so that we can see the manifestation of what we've gone through 31 days of this time of word and preaching and praying and remembering about how good God is. Amen. So it starts at 6 o'clock. It ends at 7. Amen. 6 o'clock ends at 7. Amen.
Amen.
The word says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant's ships. She brings her food from afar. Last one. She rises also while it is yet night and giveth meat to her household and a portion to her handmaidens. Father God, we bless you. We thank you for your word. We thank you for all that you have done in these 31 days. And God, we are looking forward to the first days of November, God, and how we are praying and believing and receiving and tearing, Lord God, for the greatness of who you are. Father God, right now is the intention that we need to take. Lord God, we ask you bless, Lord God, Minister Chelsea. It's already been spoken. The ground has been set for her to preach and do what she needs to do for this house. Lord God, we thank you and we honor you. We praise your name for what you're getting ready to do. We are ready. We are ready to receive. Hallelujah. From on high tonight. We love you. We honor you. We thank you. This is our prayer. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen and amen.
I'm gonna put those hands together. Bless God again tonight. Don't be seated if you can. Keep standing.
Amen. Amen. Bless your name, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus. Bless your name, God.
He's an awesome one tonight. Come on.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes.
Provider, defender, master of the universe. You know me. You are an awesome wonder. Provider, defender, master of the universe, you know me. You are an awesome wonder. Help me say, provider,
provider,
defender,
defender,
master of.
You know me.
You're an awesome.
You are an awesome.
Y'all agree?
Wonder.
Oh, he's a provider.
Provider.
A defender.
Defender.
Master of.
Master of the universe.
You know me.
You know me.
You're an awesome.
You are an awesome.
I'm glad he knows me.
My weakness, you know just where pampers the most.
I'm glad I can call you, can call you my healer. Help me say, you know me.
You know me.
You know my weakness.
My weakness.
a healer. Call you a healer. I call you healer. Oh, you know me.
You know my weakness.
You know where.
Where
I hurt the most. That's why. That's why I can stand here and call you a.
Awesome. Through these 31 days, still got 21 more to go. Come on, 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 come on. Oh, he's kept us. What a wonder you are, Jesus. What a wonder you are. You're awesome. 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 Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Lift your hands and you will and worship him, because he is. He is. Words cannot express my gratitude to you, Jesus. Everything you've done for me. If I had 10,000 tongues, I couldn't tell it all. Couldn't say it enough. But oh, you've been an awesome, awesome, awesome wonder. Yes, you have. Oh, oh, the things you do, Jesus. What a wonder you are. What a wonder you are. Oh, 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 you're an awesome, awesome wonder. Come on, LJ, tell him. Come on.
Oh, you're an awesome wonder. You're more than wonderful.
wonder of love.
Hallelujah.
What an awesome wonder.
Come on, Christian, come on, testify. Come on.
You know me, my weakness. You know me, my weakness. You know me, my weakness.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh,
bless him tonight.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless him like you're grateful. Come on, bless him for being an awesome wonder in your life. You can't tell my story and I can't tell yours. Come on, come on. He's been awesome.
Great and mighty is our God.
Preparation for this assignment, I thought about what I was doing. I received the call from LJ. Ironically, I was with family and friends back in South Carolina preparing for a feast. I remember saying, God, your timing is always perfect. But what a great opportunity to have been given a chance to commune in a holy feast with my family. And on October 31st, where the world is celebrating the devil and evilness, we are here in God's house to worship a God that gave his only son, Jesus, who gave his blood for our lives. So when I think about communion, I think about the blood that cleanses, the blood that heals, and the blood that delivers.
Oh, yes.
The blood is essential for our every being. For if it had not been for the blood, where would we be? I want to read in scripture 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, the 23rd verse. And it is in the NIVR version. I pass on to you what I have received from the Lord. On the night of the Lord Jesus was handed over to his enemies, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and he said, "This is my body. It is given for you. Every time you eat it, do it in memory of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and he said, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood. Every time you drink it, do it in memory of me." When you eat the bread and drink of the cup, you're announcing the Lord's death until he comes. So do not eat the bread or drink the cup of the Lord in the way that isn't worthy of him. If you do, you will be guilty of sinning against the body of the blood of the Lord. A person should take a careful look at himself before he eats the bread and drinks from the cup. Anyone who eats and drinks must recognize the body of the Lord. If he doesn't, God will judge him for it. This is why many of you are weak and many of you are sick. This is why a number of you have died. You may receive your elements.
What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Oh, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other found I know. It's nothing but the blood of Jesus. There is power, wonder-working power, in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, oh, wonder-working power, in the precious blood.
Let us pray. Father God, we thank you. I'm sorry. Let us receive our elements. Let us eat. And now let us drink. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for the opportunity to stand and worship you. God, we thank you for your holy communion. God, we thank you for these, your people who love you, God. God, we ask that you look upon us, touch our hearts, touch our minds, so that we may receive the word of God on tonight. God, we ask that you touch Minister Chelsea as she brings the word. God, we just bless you, we love you, and we thank you. Amen.
Of my comfort zone, some of the places in my life that's comfortable, God is challenging me. Trust and believe, for to go where I've not gone, I must do what I've not done. So I'm coming out of my comfort zone. Though it may cost me some friends, I'll walk alone. God is challenging me to trust and believe, for to go where I'm not gone, I must do what I'm not done. Of my life, I'll say yes, 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 yes. I'm coming out of my zone.
Oh, I'm being stretched to a place where I've never known. God is challenging me
to trust and be for to go where I'm not going. I must do what I've not done. No.
God is calling
to walk into my destiny.
God is challenging
to go where I'm not going. And for the rest of my the rest of my life, my answer will be yes, yes, yes. Say I'm coming out,
coming out.
Oh my, into my destiny. Coming out of my comfort zone. I'm being stretched to a place I've never known. God is challenging me. Trust and believe. If you're coming out, lift your hands and give me praise right now.
I said, if you're coming out, lift those hands and bless the name of the Lord. Come on, help me praise him right now. He's worthy to be glorified. Come on, come on, help me worship him right now. Coming out. Things that held me bound. Things that had me locked up. I'm stretching. I'm moving. Touch somebody, say, I'm coming out.
Hallelujah. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Amen. Terry, before you go, make sure Dad gets this, please. Amen. We're just going to go ahead and bless the man of God. Do what we do. I'm going to ask. I know it's kind of strange, but if I could get that spotlight kind of above my head and not directly in my eyes, it would surely bless me. Anybody can help me with that. Thank you, because I can't see a thing. Hallelujah. That was my little sister miming for me. Amen. I thank God for her, and I thank God for her walking, God. I remember the first time God allowed me to minister, I told her, as you follow me from club to club and from this to that, follow me now as I follow Christ. Amen. And that's what she has done. No, we're not perfect. Yes, we have our issues, but follow me as I follow Christ. And I'm happy about that. I'm happy about her walk. Amen. Amen. It's blessing me. It's blessing me. Because I know that the enemy tried to take my family out. Amen. My grandfather was a preacher. It's in the bloodline. Amen. Not because we wanted it, but because that's how God established it. Amen. And that goes for many of us in this place. Amen. So this is not something that I would have chosen, and I know that I'm the least likely of the bunch. Amen. Because they call me a little hood rat, but that's all right. If I'm going to be a hood rat on the other side, I'm going to be a hood rat on this side. But on this side, I'm going to have some cheese, and I'm going to draw some other hood rats on in with me. Hallelujah. So I ain't mad about it. I ain't mad about it. I'm excited about this word on tonight. I hope I don't slip and fall up here, LJ. I'm about like you, so I'm gonna be like, so if I kick my shoes off, amen and amen. God is good. God is good. Anybody been blessed this 31 days? Hasn't it been a powerful word? A life-changing word, transforming word? It's been marvelous. Amen. God has done some miraculous things. And I'm going to take these notes that I got, these nuggets that I got, and I'm going to go run on and see what the end going to be. Amen. We're going to keep pressing. I'm so excited about how God is raising up other people in the fellowship. Sister Shalanda, you know you done blessed me, girl. That's one of my prayer partners, one of my hospital visitors, and all the above. And God gonna do great things in your life. Just hold on to them and keep walking, keep walking. Sister Veronica, you blessed me when you did your communion, sis. God gonna do marvelous things. Amen. So at some point in time, we got to rejoice with one another, because this ain't no competition. This is a battle. Amen. And we all on the same side. Amen. I was on my way to work today, two cars almost hit me. I said, oh, the enemy trying to kill the word before the word get out. But how many know the devil is a liar? I begin to pray and I begin to worship in the rain. And the first song that came to my mind was, it's raining, it's pouring, the Spirit is flowing. I feel the anointing for healing and miracles. It's raining, pouring over me. It's raining, it's pouring, the Spirit is flowing. I feel the anointing for healing. He and miracles is raining, pouring over me. Then I went right into another song, and I thought, it's healing, it's raining miracles, and it's pouring over me because I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. God knows my name. Tammy, we are not forgotten. We are not forgotten. We are not forgotten. Because God knows your name. He knows your name. He knows my every thought, and he hears me when I call. He hears me when I call. Father God, we bless you in this place. Lord, we magnify you. We thank you that we're not forgotten, God, that you've made us just a little lower than the angels, that you've crowned us with glory and with honor, God. We thank you, oh God. What is man that you are mindful of him, God? We thank you that you laid down your life, oh God, that we might live, God, and have life more abundantly, oh God. We thank you for the shift in this last 30 days, God. We thank you for the sealing on this last 31st day, oh God. We ask that you do what you need to do. Allow me to decrease, that the spirit of the living God on the inside of me might increase, oh God. Allow your Holy Spirit to speak with boldness and with clarity, that it will destroy the works of the enemy, God. We thank you. We glorify you in this place. We magnify you. And it's in Jesus' name that I pray, amen. We definitely thank God for God. Somebody give it up for the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Minister Pam. Bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. You could do better than that. He's a restorer. You ought to stand on your feet and give God glory. This would be a good time to press in and thank God for the last 30 days that he's done something great and he's done something marvelous, that he snatched you from darkness into the light, that he saved some of your loved ones. Because you had your hands lifted in praise and adoration towards God. That he's healed somebody's body because you spoke it into the existence, out into the atmosphere. That you declared that no weapon formed against you in this 31 days shall prosper. Somebody ought to give God glory. Somebody ought to open your mouth to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, for there is none greater. Oh, there is none greater than our God. Oh, I'm a witness. Hallelujah. While you're on your feet, give God praise for our bishop. Amen. We definitely thank God for the man of God. If it would not have been for the God in the man of God, I would not be standing here. Amen. And I recognize that. Amen. So I don't take that lightly. I love that man. I love his wife. I love his family. Amen. You may be seated. I just thought we had to shift up and break open the atmosphere for what God has already done and what God is going to do and what he is doing at this present moment. Amen. Listen, we done had some great word. We done had some excellent word. We done had some wisdom. We done had some instruction. Amen. Some people playfully noted me as the closer since I've been closing the last few years. I said, well, amen, I'll be the closer. Hallelujah. But as soon as Bishop had told me that he wanted me to do the 31st day, instantly God put something in my spirit about my title. And I'm going to just let Brother Darrell go ahead and hit my title up one time. Follow me. Y'all just listen. Turn that up.
Regulators. You regulate any stealing of his property. Mama. But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steal if you know what I mean. Earn your keep.
Yeah.
Regulators. Mama. Regulators.
Listen to that right there.
Mama. Regulators.
Mama. Regulators. Because I'm telling you, we got a bunch of regulators in this room, and it's time for the people of God to mount up. We done got the wisdom and we done got the instruction. Now it's time to mount up and begin to regulate some stuff. Amen. So that title is simply Regulators, Mount Up. Hallelujah. Woo woo! I'm ready to mount up on some things that the enemy thought he was gonna get going on. I'm ready to regulate some stuff. I got something under my belt now. These last 30 days gave me something to fight with. Amen. And now I'm ready to mount up on the enemy. Listen, our first scripture will be 2 Corinthians 10, 3 and 5 in the Amplified. And it's going to be my focal pericope. Amen. See, I do listen to my daddy. He raising me up. Hallelujah. Woo! We ready? Amen. For though we walk, live in the flesh, we are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh and using mere human weapons. For the weapons of our warfare are not physical weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds. Inasmuch as we refute arguments and theories and reasonings and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself up against the true knowledge of God, and we lead every thought and purpose away captive into the obedience of Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One. Listen, as regulators for the upbuilding and the moving forward of the kingdom of God, we have to know what our weapons are, and we have to know how to rightly use our weapons. Amen. Chaplain Lane reminded us that there is a table that was prepared before us in the presence of our enemies, but that this table was not prepared with food, but that it actually had weapons on it that we needed to use to be successful in the day of battle. That these weapons that were on our table would help us rise up out of the ashes of adversity. Amen. As he was talking, I could relate to this table, and I realized that in my own mind that I too had equated this table with being a table prepared with food, and this might be a time that I can sit down and eat and relax. Amen. But it's not a good thing to relax at the table that is before your enemy. Amen. And I say enemy because though there are many adversaries, there is one enemy. Amen. Amen. Yes, he uses people, places, and things to distract us. Amen. But what I'm finding out is when I take my eye and place them on those people, places, and things, Minister Fam, that distracts me, and I've taken my eye off the enemy, now the spirit of distraction has come, and I'm in the perfect position and posture for a hostile takeover. Amen. What's a hostile takeover? It's just simply when the devil takes me from walking in the spirit realm into operating in my flesh. Amen. That's a hostile takeover, because I'm no longer doing what thus saith the Lord, but now I'm operating in my carnality, if you will. Now, the Bible is clear when it speaks of these things, because Ephesians 6 and 12 in the Amplified through 18 says this: for we wrestle not with flesh and blood, contending only with physical opponents, but against despotisms, against the powers, against the master spirits who are the world's rulers of this present darkness, against the spirit forces of wickedness in heavenly places, the supernatural sphere. Therefore, put on God's complete armor, that you may be able to resist and stand your ground on the evil day of danger. And having done all the crisis demands. Now, I like that right there. After you've done all the crisis demands, that means after you've done all, after everything that has come against you, that is chaotic, that you can't do nothing else, after all you've done in the crisis demands, to stand firmly in your place. Now, I like that. Stand therefore, hold your ground, having tightened the belt of truth around your loins. How many know you better have the belt of truth in this walk? Having put on the breastplate of integrity. It's something about integrity that the saints need to grab a hold of in this season, because for so long the church has manifested ill will towards the people outside the walls because our integrity was not intact. But as we're redressing ourselves with the weapons of our warfare, our integrity now is going to come back intact. Amen. The scriptures goes on to say, and of moral rectitude and right standing with God. How many want to be in right standing with God in this season? And having shod your feet in preparation to face the enemy with the firm-footed stability, the promptness, and the readiness produced by the good news of the gospel of peace. Amen. Lift up over all the covering shield of saving faith, upon which you can quench all the flaming missiles, not just the darts, but how many know the enemy is sending missiles into the camp? Amen. That you quench all the flaming missiles of the wicked one, and take on the helmet of salvation, and the sword that the Spirit wields, which is the Word of God. How many know it's the Word of God that destroys the yoke of bondage in your life? Nothing but the Word of God will destroy the yoke of bondage. It's not my slick talk. It's not my money that I can offer you. Amen. It might help you, but it's the Word of God that's going to destroy the yoke of bondage off of your life. Amen. Amen. The Bible goes on to say, pray at all times. All times, on every occasion, whatever you're going through, continue to pray. In every season, whether it's a good season, a bad season, a valley season, a mountain season, continue to pray. Amen. In the spirit, with all manner of prayer and entirety. To that end, keep alert. How many know we've been asleep too long? The Bible says, keep alert and watch with strong purpose. Amen. Perseverance. Interceding in the behalf of all the saints. All the saints. God's consecrated people. Can I help somebody right here? That last part of that scripture said all the saints. Let me help you how God helped me. Even the ones that gets on my nerves. Amen. Because you know we done said it. They getting on my nerves. I can't stand them today. But I'm spending too much time concentrating on them getting on my nerves. And the Bible says I have stopped praying. I mean, you know, I take my whoopings when they come. Amen. I'm a big girl at this. Amen. If you don't get chastised by the Lord, the Bible says you are considered a bastard. And I've been homeless and I've been an orphan 3 times over. So today I'm going to claim my father. And today I'm going to be a child. And I'm going to take my whoopings as they come. Amen. From the bishop and from God. Amen. Because that's who he gave me to govern my life. Amen. I asked God to free the body of Christ from the spirit of offense. Amen. Because that's what we need to break through a stronghold, because the spirit of offense is a stronghold. Either I'm too easily offended, Elder Mo, or I'm always offending somebody. Oh, I pray, God, release me from the spirit of offense. Because I can't go nowhere. Because let me tell you what the spirit of offense does. It places a fence around you. You in captivity. You in bondage. When you operate in the spirit of offense. So I'm praying that God knock down the spirit of offense in the body of Christ. Amen. We're going to read Ephesians 6 and 12 in the Message Bible. So that we can get a better understanding of what God is saying. This is no afternoon athletic contest. that we'll walk away from and forget about in a couple of hours. This is for keeps, a life or death fight to the finish against the devil and all his angels. Be prepared. You're up against far more than you can handle on your own. Take all the help you can get. Stop turning your back on the brothers and sisters, because we need all the help that we can get, because this is a battle I can't win on my own. The Bible said so. Amen. He said, every weapon God has issued you, the effectual fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much. That means that we as the righteous are some of God's weapons. Amen. Amen. I don't know why I said that, but that was the Holy Ghost, so we said it anyway. Amen. Has issued you so that when it is all over, but the shouting, you'll be able to stand on your feet. The Bible goes on to say truth, righteousness, peace, faith, and salvation are more than just words. Learn how to apply them. You'll need them throughout your life. God's word is an indispensable weapon. In the same way, prayer is essential in this ongoing warfare. Amen. Pray hard. The Bible says pray long. Pray for your brothers and your sisters. Keep your eyes open. Keep each other's spirits up so that no one falls behind or drops out. I'm saying that's important right there. See, our mindsets in this battle from this day forward has to be that of Jesus the Christ. See, he left the 99 and went and got the one. Someone say, no one gets left behind. I want you to say that loud. No one gets left behind. Amen. Because as a man speaketh, so is he. So if you believe that and speak that out of your mouth, you won't leave no one behind. Because that'll always be on your mind. And if I make it over, they're going to make it over. If I don't make it over, they don't make it over. Amen. Hallelujah. We know that we're in the Joshua generation. We've been talking about this for some time now. That we're being mobilized for manifestation. But in doing so, we have to constantly realize that being mobilized is an action word. They've taught us that over these last 30 days. We have to do some footwork, if you will, to get to activating our motivation, our mobilization. We have to do footwork so that it can be activated. Amen. So that we can successfully get to our manifestation. Something has to be activated, footwork, activation, then manifestation, mobilization, then manifestation. Amen. As soon as Bishop began to tell me that I was going to do the 31st night, I began to hear in my spirit the first part of Ecclesiastes 7 and 8. I didn't give it to you guys, so you don't have to go there. But it just simply says, better is the end of a thing than the beginning of it. Amen. What am I saying? See, I don't feel like I got some great revelation in the word or that this night would be greater than the nights before. But just simply because as I thought about it, I know for myself, by the time 52 days rolls around, I'm in need of a refreshing. Amen, because this is our new year. So this means I've been struggling, battling all year. So I'm in need of a restoration. I'm in need for my cup to be filled up so that I can be coming, flowing, and running over once again. Amen. I'm in need to be reminded that this God that I serve is the mediator of a better covenant. Amen. And that because I'm in covenant with him and not with the world and not with the devil, I am blessed beyond blessed. No matter what it looks like, I'm blessed coming and I'm blessed going. I'm the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. I am the very apple of God's eye. But sometimes it takes for 52 days to roll back around for me to remember that. Amen. I have to remind myself that I need to get here night after night so that I can repeatedly hear in my ear words of wisdom, Elder Mo, and words of instruction that come from many bellies but is created by one source, God himself. And it's all lined up in unison with the gift of the house that was given to us out of God's very own heart in Bishop Mark C. McGuire. Amen. This is who governs our life. This is who is over this house. This is why we have to take better care of the gift that was given. Amen. See, I understand that from October the 1st to October the 31st, I would be fully energized. I feel stronger at the end of the month than I do at the beginning of the month. Amen. Now I feel like fighting, prophetess. I feel like fighting now. See, now again, not that I had given up the fight, but just that my fight had got a little weak along the way. Amen. But now that I feel like fighting again, and I've come as many nights that I possibly could have came, I've reduced my joy. Amen. And the Bible says that the joy of the Lord is my strength. Amen. So I'm feeling a little stronger now. Amen. And I'm glad about that. My fight is up. Amen. When God put this regulator's mount up in my spirit, it's because he knew that after all the powerful word that was going to go forth, after it was all said and done, that we, the people of God in this house, would believe that we can regulate some stuff now. Yeah, we believe that we can regulate some stuff. We're back in the driver's seat with the Holy Ghost being our navigation system. Amen. We're back on focus and we're back on target now. Whatever the enemy had planned, because he didn't fulfill it, it's over now. Because it's a new year. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Amen. Let's just look at this word regulators for a moment. First off, it just simply means a person or a thing that regulates. Amen. As I was looking up the word, I read this. There is a valve for regulating the pressure of flowing gas to maintain a predetermined pressure. Instantly, of course, I began to think about what gas meant for us here at the Potter's House. For those that don't know or knew, we know that Bishop told us long ago that gas simply represented our gratitude and our attitude and our servitude. Amen. And the only one that could help us maintain the predetermined pressure is the all-time regulator for us in this dispensation, which is the Holy Ghost. How many know you got to have communication with the Holy Spirit? My sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they will not follow. It was expedient that God left, that Christ left. Why? So that he could send the paraclete, that he could send the one that would give you wisdom and instruction. But if you don't have a relationship with the Holy Ghost, you're going to be a vagabond because you don't know his voice. Amen. What I'm finding out that in my gratitude and in my attitude and in my servitude, that this is the pressure that keeps the enemy off of me. When I'm operating fully at my potential in this, do I operate the same on Monday as Tuesday? Absolutely not. Am I lacking in one of the, or strong in one and lacking in the other? Probably so. But what I'm saying is that I do got a full understanding of that. It's my attitude and my gratitude and my servitude that will help push the enemy back. It takes pressure to push something or someone back. Amen. And sometimes that pressure has to come from you being squeezed up out of your flesh. Amen. Sometimes it comes with correction. Amen. To get your gratitude up, to get your servitude up, to get your attitude at full capacity. Amen. It takes pressure. Amen. I'm telling you that what we have gained over the last 30 nights, and prayerfully you'll gain something over this last night, I believe that we, the saints of God in this house, and anybody who's tuned in, because we know you're watching, we can do stuff that we've never done before. Yeah, I'm feeling like we can take on some stuff that we've never taken on before. I'm feeling like that when people said that we couldn't, I believe that we can. I'm feeling like, Minister Pam, that we will, and that the wall has begun to start turning, and there ain't no turning back. There'll be no half-stepping. Amen. God has given us power. He's given us fortitude to do what we've never done before. But I'm just going to warn you with what he said to me. I can't lose my commitment to God, to the house of God, to the man of God, to the people of God, to the places and things where God is trying to send me. I cannot lose my commitment or be tired. Why? Because he's giving me fresh wind. A new start in a new year. Amen. He said, I can't lose my cohesiveness to the word of God. It has to be melted within me. Hide my word in your heart that you might not sin against me. These are the things that he's speaking in this season to me. Amen. That it's time for me to regulate and it's time for me to mount up. Amen. I'm finding out that there can be no thin skin in this next dispensation, in this next transition. Thin skin will not be able to be a part of it. So I'm telling you that you need to pray the prayer that I prayed a few years on back when my skin was being broken down because it was thin because of what the enemy was trying to do. What I'm saying is ask for thicker skin because when the skin breaks down, there's a breach. Now, God can help you with that because in the Bible, he says that he's the restorer of the breach. Because that's where offense comes in thin-skinned people. Amen. Somebody asks you to do something, your skin's so thin it irritates your muscles. Your muscles get to shaking. You don't know what to do. You can't move forward, but you know that the Spirit said they're in charge. But your flesh says, I can't move. Walking around with spiritual MS. Come on. Come on. Muscles weak. Can't move forward. Collapsing under instruction. Can't happen in this next walk. Amen. Well, the Bible's clear. If there's a breakdown in the house, the Bible says that a house divided against itself cannot stand. So what am I saying? We have to do whatever we can to make sure there's no division in the house. Amen. You have to have that spirit of discernment. Some people can take some things said to them that other people can't take. So you have to know when to speak and when not to speak, when to shut up and when not to shut up. Amen. I'm not talking about not speak or say what God say because they're babes and don't want to grow up. Some of y'all gonna get spoke to, even myself, at this season, where it's gonna irritate your flesh because you got to get beyond your flesh. At some point, you got to walk in the Spirit. At some point. Amen. So some things are gonna get said to you, but I'm telling you right now, if it irritates your flesh, it's probably God. It's probably God trying to get you out of that place that you in. Amen. Wonder why you can't never be comfortable. Amen. Let somebody help grow you up. Ain't nothing wrong with it. I tell my little sister what to do all the time. She my little sister. I can tell her what I want. She ain't always got to listen to it, but I ain't going to tell her nothing to hurt her. I ain't going to tell her nothing to harm her. That's why I said, follow me as I follow Christ. You follow me to every bar. You follow me to every weed house. You follow me to every this and that. Now follow me as I follow Christ, because what we've done on the other side, it ain't working. It was a lie. Amen. So follow me this way. Amen. Listen. In this season, and I don't know what time it is, but I'm going to go ahead and finish anyway. Amen. In this season, what I'm finding out, what God is showing me, that when my flesh begins to overtake me, and for you super saints, amen, I'm trying to get there. Come on. But I ain't there yet. So my flesh does tend to rise up. Amen. I can't be holier than thou all the time. I try to stay in God's grace, but it's not always there. Amen. His grace is there, but I'm not always operating in it. Let me say it like that. Amen. Amen. But when God's, when my flesh comes upon me and I struggle with my own battle to separate my natural realm, meaning my carnal realm, from the spiritual realm of my own existence, God has taken me to a scripture that he wants me to maintain in my spirit. Not just maintain, but he said it's time to meditate on this. Amen. Why? Because what I'm finding out is that when I'm murmuring and I'm complaining and I'm doing things of this nature, that I've forgotten what has taken place. I've forgotten why am I doing what I'm doing. And I've forgotten who am I doing it for. Yeah, yeah. Isaiah 9 and 6 through 8 in the King James says this: "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth," and somebody say, "forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this." How many know it's something about the zeal of the Lord of hosts? I don't even have to perform nothing. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Amen. Then I love the way verse 8, when I had to get up and run when I seen verse 8, Pam. I said, I read it a couple times and I just got to thinking about it. The Lord sent a word into Jacob, and it had lightened upon Israel. I thought, oh my God. God, I am so glad that I serve a God that would send a word straight through my Jacob tendencies and would begin to light up the Israel in me, the place where I'm operating as God's true and obedient child, the place where I understand the power that has been given through Christ. That in fact, that me as a child of God, I should no longer be deceived. No longer be deceived. That nothing by any means shall harm me. That nothing by any means can overtake me. Because I shall no longer be deceived. Whoo! Something about God speaking straight through your Jacob, when he can speak straight through your mess. Straight through your proclivities and light up Israel in you. Because when Israel's lit up, oh, the battle is on now. It's when you remember what Bishop said, that God loves Jacob and he loves Israel. So I ain't got to be guilty and shameful and all bent over about my Jacob. I'm gonna wait for God to speak straight through him to my Israel. Oh, I want you to know that word bless me, Deacon Boy. Do you hear me? Woo! I had to run a little bit and come back and finish. First John says this, 3:7-8 says, "Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of the devil. For the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of evil, of the devil." The Amplified Bible says it like this: "He was made visible to undo, destroy, loosen, and dissolve the works of the devil, dissolve the works the devil has done." Oh, how many know Christ did his part? Oh, it's time for the regulators to mount up and do ours. Because the Bible says, greater works shall we do. Amen. So if this cause that the Son of Man was made manifest that he might destroy the works of the enemy, greater works shall we do. For this cause was we brought into the kingdom of God. To destroy, to undo, to loosen what the enemy has done. It's time for us to undo what the enemy has done. Amen. Somebody say, mount up. See, God showed me this. When you mount up, you got to know this is where the rubber meets the road. When you mount up, you got to know that this is the place where you don't get to look back. For the Bible says, don't put your hands to the plow and look back. For if you do, you're not fit for the kingdom of God or his righteousness. Amen. This is a place where you tie your hands to the horns of the altar, come what may. Amen. This is the place where you have to believe that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, that the gates of hell shall not prevail. This is that place. When you mount up, this is when you believe that without a shadow of a doubt. Amen. When you mount up, see, when soldiers mount up and they're getting ready to go into battle, this is the place where they believe with all of their heart that they're going to win the battle. Oh, they don't doubt that. They don't think that they're going to lose the battle when they mount up. Before the man says, go forward, they believe that they're going over to possess the land. See, for the saints of God, in this season, when we mount up, this is when the spirit of Esther comes upon us. I'm going to mount up and go take the enemy's territory. And if I perish, then I'll perish. This is that place. This is that season. All the instruction has gone forth. Wisdom has come. It's time to mount up. Amen. This is the time when you mount up. It's time to stand upon the platform, prophetess, that God has given you. Amen. This is the time that you stand up on that platform that he's given you in the earth realm, Minister Perrin. Amen. Beyond singing to the glory of God, woman of God. This is that place. Amen. Where we stand strong, prepared and ready to launch into the enemy's territory. Without fear. Why? Because the Bible says that God didn't give us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Oh yeah, if you reign with him, you gonna have to suffer with him. That's what the Bible says. But it also says after you have suffered just a little while, he'll make you perfect. He'll strengthen you. Amen. And I love when the Bible says he'll settle you. There's something about the settling in the spirit of God. Amen. So this is the place where you're ready to launch into the enemy's territory. That you're going to conquer what's beyond the Jordan without a shadow of the doubt. Listen, I'm reminded of the fathers of faith, Minister Pam, in Hebrews. Because in order to go forth and conquer this land, you have to go in faith. You got to go in faith. For without faith, it's impossible to please God. Now that's what the Bible says. So Hebrews 11 and 15 through 40, and I'm going to just read it, and I just want you to take this in. Because when I took it in, it did something to my mindset. So I want you to be prepared to get your mindset change, because this is going to help you regulate and mount up. The Bible says this: if they were homesick for the old country, they could have gone back at any time they wanted. But they were after a far better country than that, heaven's country. You can see why God is so proud of them and has a city waiting for them. See, by faith, Abraham, at the time of testing, offered Isaac back to God, acting in faith. He was as ready to return the promised son, his only son, as he had been to receive him. And this after he had already been told, "Your descendants shall come from Isaac." Abraham figured that if God wanted to, he could raise the dead. In a sense, that's what happened when you received Isaac back alive from off the altar. By an act of faith, Isaac reached into the future as he blessed Jacob and Esau. By an act of faith, Jacob on his deathbed blessed each of Joseph's sons in turn, blessing him with the God's blessing, not his own, as he bowed worshipfully upon his staff. By an act of faith, Joseph, while dying, prophesied the exodus of Israel and made arrangements for his own burial. By an act of faith, Moses' parents hid him away for 3 months after his birth. They saw the child's beauty and they braved the king's decree. By faith, Moses, when grown, refused the privileges of the Egyptian royal house. He chose a hard life with God's people rather than an opportunistic soft life of sin with the oppressors. He valued suffering in the Messiah's camp far greater than Egyptian wealth because he was looking ahead and anticipating the payoff. I'm trying to tell you, don't go back, look ahead and anticipate the payoff. By an act of faith, he turned his heels on Egypt. Indifferent to the king's blind rage, because he didn't have no fear. He knew God was on his side. He had his eye on the one no one can see, and he kept right on going. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But it is the Lord that will bring you out of them all. Keep on going. Amen. By an act of faith, he kept the Passover feast and sprinkled Passover blood on each house so that the destroyer of the firstborn wouldn't touch them. By an act of faith, Israel walked through the Red Sea on dry ground. The Egyptians tried it and drowned. By faith, the Israelites marched around the walls of Jericho for 7 days and the walls fell flat. How many know he's the same God yesterday, today, and forever? So what am I saying? Every impenetrable wall that you could not get through, we declare in this season that it has to come down. It's coming down. We decree it. The Bible says if I decree a thing, God will establish it. Every impenetrable wall is coming down in the name of Jesus. By an act of faith, Rahab, the Jericho harlot, welcomed the spies and escaped the destruction that came on those who refused to trust God. This is a season where you got to trust him even when you don't understand it. Amen. The Bible says, and I could go on and on and on, but I've run out of time. There are so many more. Gideon, Barak, Samson, Japheth, David, Samuel, the prophets. Through acts of faith, they toppled kingdoms, made justice work, took the promises for themselves. How many know it's time to take the promises for ourselves? Amen. They were protected from lions, fires, and swords thrust, turned disadvantages into advantages. I just prophesied right there. Somebody's disadvantage is going to turn into your advantage. Amen. They won battles, rerouted enemy, alien armies. Women received their loved ones back from the dead. There were those who, under torture, refused to give in and go free, preferring something better. Somebody say the resurrection. Amen. Others braved abuse, whips, and yes, chains and dungeons. We have stories of those who were stoned, sawed in two, murdered in cold blood. Stories of vagrants wandering the earth in animal skins, homeless, friendless, powerless. The world didn't deserve them, making their way as best they could on the cruel edges of the world. Not one of these people, even though their lives of faith were exemplary, got their hands on what was promised. God had a better plan for us. Somebody ought to shout right there, because you know you can't stand what they went through. God had a better plan for us, that their faith and our faith would come together to make one complete whole. Their lives of faith not complete from ours. Disciplined in a long distance race. God took me down to Hebrews 12 and 1 through 3. It says, do you see what this means? All these pioneers who blazed the way, all these veterans cheering us on, it means we better get on with it. Strip down, start running, and never quit. No extra spiritual fat, no parasitic sins. Aha! Keep your eye on Jesus, who both began and finished this race that we're in. Study how he did it, because he never lost sight of where he was headed. That's what's wrong with us. We lose sight of where we're headed. Amen. That exhilarating finish in with God, in and with God. He could put up with anything along the way. Cross, shame, whatever. And now he's there in the place of honor right alongside God. When you find yourselves flagging in your faith, go over that story again, item by item, that long litany of hostility he plowed through. Oh, we ain't been through nothing. That will shoot adrenaline through your souls. It will recharge you because you find out that you ain't been through nothing. And all that the fathers of faith had to go through ought to remind you that if they can do it, so can we. Amen. Bishop is our priest. He has stepped in the water. God has made the water to go hither and thither. The clarion call has been called. It's been sounded over the last 30 days to be equipped, learning how to be regulators. Now it's time to mount up and earn your keep. Amen. And I'm going to leave you with these words of wisdom and instruction in the Word of God. Because we have to be reminded why we are doing what we are doing. Ephesians 4, 1 through 13 in Amplified. I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, appeal to and beg you to walk, lead a life worthy of the divine calling to which you have been called, with behavior that is a credit to the summons to God's service, living as becomes you, with complete lowliness of mind, humility, meekness, unselfishness, gentleness, mildness, with patience, bearing with one another and making allowances because you love one another. Let me help you right here. Just because I'm jacked up and you've seen some of my proclivities, this is where you make allowance for me because you love me.
Yeah. Come on, come on.
This ain't where you judge me and tear me down and go talk to the saints about me. This is where you make allowance for me to get over where I'm supposed to be. Why? Because you're praying for me.
Yeah.
Amen. Because you love one another. Be eager and strive earnestly to guard and keep the harmony and oneness and produced by the Spirit in the binding power of peace. There's something about the power in peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as there is also one hope that belongs to the calling you received. There is one Lord, one faith, and one baptism, one God and Father of us all, who is above all, sovereign over all, pervading all and living in us all. Yet grace, God's unmerited favor, who was given to each of us individually, not discriminatingly, but in different ways. We got to catch that. Given in different ways, in proportion to the measure of Christ's rich and bounteous gifts. Therefore it is said, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive. He led a train of vanquished foes. How many know your foes are being vanquished, and they're being vanquished by the train? You can look back and see the vanquished foes. That's a good thing. And he bestowed gifts on men. I'm going to skip down to verse 11. And his gifts were varied. He himself appointed and gave men to us. Some to be apostles, and not men, but humans. Let's get it together. Some apostles, special messengers. Some prophets, inspired teachers and expounders. Some evangelists, preachers of the gospel, traveling missionaries. some pastors, shepherds of his flock, and teachers. His intention was the perfecting and the full equipping of the saints, his consecrated people, that they should do the work of ministering towards upbuilding, building up the body of Christ's body, the church, that it might develop until we all attain oneness in the faith and in the comprehension of the full and accurate knowledge of the Son of God, that we might arrive at really mature manhood, the completeness of personality, which is nothing less than the standard heights of Christ's own perfection, the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ and the completeness found in him. Amen. That's a scripture to meditate on day and night. God has given us gifts in the body. We need to respect the gifts. You might not understand why that person got the gift, but the gifts and callings are without repentance. Amen. Prophetess, I'm going to tell you something. God been speaking to me about you. The glimpse and the visions that you've seen are not of your past, they're of your future. Doing what you know that you can do. Doing what God has placed in you. That's why I didn't say Janelle, I said prophetess. Because I'm speaking to the gift. Come on. That's been lying dormant. It's not going to be birthed, but it's going to be rebirthed, and it's coming out of your mouth. Jesus. It's going to come out of your mouth because out of your belly flows rivers of living water. Dormant but not gone. But God said that there are people in your life that have comforted you through your struggle, that have become good friends of yours. But in this season, there's going to be a separation. Not because you don't love them, but because you got to get back to what God has you to do. There's too much power and too much anointing in your belly to continue to lie dormant. It's going to burst through, but it's going to take for you. And this is what he said to me too, so I'm not just saying it to you. That we have to get out of our carnality comfortability. That we have to get back to that place where there's a stretching. That it's uncomfortable. That some of those people that you've made friends with will be upset, but that's okay. Because your loyalty is not to them, it's to God. Your loyalty is to God. So you have to do what you need to do to get back to where you're supposed to be, operating in full potential of God. There's power in your belly. We knew it when you came. You spoke to my life years ago, and you told me that I need to hold my own part. And now I'm speaking that very word back to you. I don't know if it's going to be done here, but I know that it's going to be done. Those glimpses that you see of doing what you've done is not your past, it's your future. So God gonna do it. And when you do separate for a season, you have to let them know that this is just for a season, because your loyalty is to God. When you get to where you need to be, they can get to where they need to be, because they can't get there until you get there. And that's what God spoke to me over this whole thing. And I knew that I was going to say it to you when you spoke to me online today. And we never talk online. Amen. So I knew what I was hearing was true. So I hope you ain't mad that I gave you that word, girl. But that's what thus saith the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm telling you, in this season, as we mount up, as we regulate some stuff, I'm going to open the altar for prayer. We're going to give, and then I'm going to pray. So if you want to stay around, because in this season, we need to come together and realize that we have to regulate some stuff. Bless you, sis. It's time to mount up. And if you haven't mounted up like you're supposed to, or you don't know if you have the strength to mount up, or if there's been some things in the way, I'm just going to come in agreement with you. Come and bring your tithes and your offerings and your gifts. And if you want that prayer, stay at the altar. Amen? Stay at the altar. God's going to do something. This is our last night. This is where the charge goes forth. Amen. This is where we do what we need to do. Amen. I don't care. Get a penny. Sow into this word. Not into me, but sow into the word. Because I know that it was from God. It's not the amount, it's the weight. If you ain't got one, you borrow one. But everybody ought to put something in this basket so that you could connect with what the word said. Amen. Because God's going to do something powerful in this season. And he's going to do it through his people. If you want to connect with that prayer, stay at the altar after you give. Amen. We thank you, Lord. We bless you for these 52 days. We thank you, God, for your faithful. You are awesome and you are holy, sovereign, creator of heaven and earth. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Hallelujah. This ain't about you not being able to do something or you haven't been doing something. This is just a charge to go forward. Amen. For strength, for wisdom, for insight into God's word. The power not to be stagnated.